السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him, we seek His aid, His guidance, His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil actions and evil consequences of ourselves. Whomever Allah guides, there is no misguidance for this person, and whomever Allah misguides, there is no guidance for this person. I bear witness, there is no God worthy of worship except Allah alone, having no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can you hear me, everybody? Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Okay. We're starting, inshallah, the second class about Hamzat al-Wasl for the Tajweed classes. The meaning of Hamzat al-Wasl, it occurs only at the beginning of the word, which starting with second letter. It occurs without any haraka on it. The way it is written like small sad, Hamzat al-Wasl, okay, over the alif. The way of pronunciation, it has two cases, whether to be pronounced or to be skipped, as shown in the following diagram. Hamzat al-Wasl pronounced if the reader starts reading from the word starting with Hamzat al-Wasl. So Hamzat al-Wasl should be pronounced. Means we're gonna search for the Hamza, we're gonna pronounce it with Kasra or Dhamma or Fatha. طيب, what time we skip it? If the reader connect the word which begins with the Hamzat al-Wasl with the letter or the word preceding it. So the letter preceding Hamzat al-Wasl is directly connected to the letter following Hamzat al-Wasl. This means we drop it or skip it. If we are making wasl, connecting. Connecting means making wasl. Type. We're going to see what time we skip it or drop it, Hamzat al-Wasl. If the reader connects the word which begins with Hamzat al-Wasl with the letter preceding it, this letter preceding Hamzat al-Wasl here in these examples. If I connect it with the letter behind it, I'm going to drop Hamzat al-Wasl. I will not pronounce it at all. The letter preceding Hamzat al-Wasl is directly connected to the letter following Hamzat al-Wasl. This way we drop it or skip it in the wasl, in connecting. Here, if I say bism, from the ba to the sin, bism, bism, lib, libnihi, I drop the alif, wabanaha, from the waw to the ba. فاتباع فبعثوا and so on. All of them same. We have either ba, either lam, either waw, either fa. Fa, 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 waw, lam, waw, 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 waw. Here, asatirul from the ra, which has dhamma to the lam second. Asatirul awwaleen. I don't pronounce this at all. If I connect anything before Hamzat al-Wasl to the letter after Hamzat al-Wasl, I drop it. Because we call it Hamzat al-Wasl, we drop it if we make wasl. Wasl means connection. طيب, here is exercise. Nakalal from the lam to the lam. Lam fatha to the lam saki. Nakalal akhirata wal. From the waw to the lam. Wal-oola. Wa-dha-ka-ras. From the rah to the sin. Wa-dha-ka-ras-na rabbihi fa-salla. From the fa to the lam. فالمدبرات أمرا أولئك هم ال... Here we have another rule also merging with همزة الوصل. If the letter before همزة الوصل is ساكن also and the letter after it of course is ساكن because we get this همزة الوصل if the letter following it is ساكن. Huh? You see always the letter after همزة الوصل is ساكن. طيب here ساكن. طيب what I do if I have one ساكن before it and one ساكن after it, what to do? We have another rule to tell us we have to get rid of the first ساكن by one of the four ways. Either put دمة, either put كسرة, either put فتحة means change the سكون into another vowel. Either كسرة, فتحة, دمة, either drop it if it is letter of the mad. Drop the mad letter completely and go from the letter before the mad to the other ساكن here. Of course همزة الوصل we drop it because we connected, we making وصل. Here هم originally has سكون, ميم الجمع originally has سكون. طيب why I put دمة here? Because the letter following it is ساكن. I can't connect two ساكن words, the end of the first one with the beginning of the second one. Both of them ساكن, I have to do something with the first ساكن. For ميم الجمع, I put دمة. همو, I say همو الكفرة تل. همو الكفرة الفجرة. إذي, here also إذ has سكون. Most of the words we put for them كسر. Most of the 90% we put كسرة. What time I put دمة? For two things only. ميم الجمع and the واو of lean. We will see it inshallah later if we find the word. And we put فتحة for two words only. For noon of من, the word من, preposition, حرف الجر. Or for the beginning of Ali Imran if I connect it. Inshallah, we say this, we see this later. But let me tell you, here we have to get rid of the first second by Dhamma. هُمُ الْكَفَرَةُ الْفَجَرَةِ إِذِي, most of the time we put كسر. إِذِي مْبَعَثَ أَشْقَاهَا. إِذِي, from here to here, I dropped the همزة الوصل. فَأَرَاهُ الْ, from the ha to the lam. فأراه الآية ال, from the تم مربوطة فتحة to the lam. الآية الكبرى. You remember last time we say if we start with it, what time I put فتحة? If it is ال حرف we put فتحة and we put دمة when the third letter has compulsory دمة. And so on. Here, بالوادل. Here also, بالوادل, from the دال to the lam. بالوادل مقدس. The lam first, before the meme which has them. Lam second. بالوادل مقدس. فادخولي في, فاد. We drop the, يسأل. فادخولي في عبادي. وبرزة تل, تل. Here تاء ساكن وجيب كسرة. وبرزت الجحيم ولقد رآه بالأفق المبين. أساطير ال, from the ره to the lam. أولين. كتاب ال, from the باء to the lam. كتاب الأبرار. Now the second pronouncing همزة الوصل. Will be assigned with Dhamma if the third letter of the verb has Dhamma, but this Dhamma has to be original Dhamma, means لازم Dhamma, means compulsory Dhamma, not temporary Dhamma. Here you find most of these are verbs, and the second letter is ساكن also, because we start همزة الوصل of the following letter is ساكن to start. You can't start any ساكن word in the Arabic except if you put همزة وصل before it and give همزة الوصل the همزة قطع with كسرة or ضمة or فتح. What time I put ضمة if it is verb and the third letter has, if I count 1, 2, 3, I count همزة الوصل 1, 2, 3 has compulsory ضم. أبتلي أتلو أجتثت أحشرو. You make, you collect your lips for the dhamma and then spread your lips one more time for the second letter, then collect it again for the other dhamma. أخرج أدخل أذكر أركض أستحفظ أشدد أضطر أعبد أغدو أقنوتي أنقص أمكث أقعد أنشر لا أنشز أنشز أنصرني أنظر. طيب exceptional, there is five words. The third letter has dhamma, but we can't start it with dhamma, with the hamzat al-wasl. We're gonna start. I don't know what sister who open camera, please. Don't open camera. طيب the following words are only verbs in Quran, the only verbs in Quran. Which has dhamma on the third letter, and the reader should assign kasra to hamzat al-wasl if he starts reading with it. You can say uttaqu uqdu, la, you're gonna say e ittaqu iqdu إيتوني. We're gonna switch this also to ياء. إيتوني like in سورة الأحقاف. إبنوا إمشوا. Why? Why I'm gonna start these five verbs in the whole Quran with كسرة, even the third letter has ضمة. We said that before that the condition to start with ضمة, that this ضمة has to be compulsory ضمة, means permanent dhamma, not temporary dhamma. So what makes this dhamma temporary and to make me start with kasra? Because they said that this originally kasra, because it was ya, and this we switch it to dhamma because to be suitable to the waw. Like iqdiyu, iqdiyu, it was ya. Iqdiyu, di, di. It wasn't dhamma. It was kasra. اقضي or اقضي اقضي. If I put wow, I have to make temporary dhamma mute. Temporary dhamma is not original dhamma. Also this one et, but I put dhamma temporary. This mean this dhamma ibni. Imshi, originally yeah, not well, not dhamma. But I put temporary dhamma to be suitable to the waw, to be suitable to the waw behind it. This mean is not compulsory dhamma, is not dhamma all the time. Then I have to start with hamza with kasra. You have to memorize these words. Ittaqu, iqdu, إيتوني ابنو امشوا. طيب همزة الوصل will be assigned with كسرة if the third letter of the verb has فتحة or كسرة. Means if it is not ضمة compulsory ضمة we gonna make كسرة for everything if, except for the التعريف which is حرف وبوت فتحة. That's it. إذ ثاقلتم اجعل احمل اخسأوا اداركوا استعينوا اشرح اصبر اصطفى اضرب التقيتم اعمل اهتزت اهبط انتظروا. Still we have a lot of them كسرة. This means you have to memorize the few which is what time you put ضمة what time you put فتح. Okay, you don't have to memorize what time كسرة because كسرة is most of them. خلاص you don't have to memorize what time كسرة. These seven words or seven names, we call it سماعي, means we heard them, the Arab repeating them this way. إثنان, we write it like this, with starting with همزة الوصل. But if we start with it, we put كسر. إثنان, إثنتين, one for masculine, one for feminine. ابن, ابنه, or ابنت. We could be with تيم مربوطة or تيم مفتوح. He here increased one like this, but it's the same. من اثنان اثنتان أو اثنتين ابن ابنة امرؤ امرأة اسم one two three four five six seven. But he added here the one who made this book جزاه الله خيرا different styles from the same word. ابن you could say ابني you add ياء ابنة or ابنت you could ابنتي but it's the same one. امرؤ with ضمة or امرئ امرئ with كسرة it's the same word. But what you have to memorize اثنان اثنتان ابن ابنة امرؤ امرأة اسم seven only. طيب these names but we start them with كسرة. Okay, I'm gonna skip this, which is the conclusion. I'll come back to it, inshallah, at the end. Now we have exercise. طيب, let me come to it now. Here, pronouncing همزة الوصل at the beginning of nouns. إمري, إمرأة, ابن, ابنة, اسم. اثنين اثنتين this with كسرة. طيب the only one with فتحة لام التعريف nouns with لام التعريف ال you say الذين right if you start this word what you gonna read say الذين العالمين الجبال الله الأرض and so on ال only with فتحة everything else with كسرة except if it is the third letter has compulsory dhamma. طيب طيب here for verbs if the third letter of the verb has dhamma compulsory ها ادخلوا اقتلوا انظر and so on here the third letter has كسرة or فتحة we start with كسرة اهدنا او اقرأ we accept these five verbs we said we have to memorize it inshallah these five verbs we have to memorize it which the third letter has dhamma but it's temporary dhamma it's not original because it's supposed to be ya ittaqi ittaqi صح اقضي ايتي ابني امشي يعني امشيو but we switch it to dhamma to be suitable to the waw to be easy to read it okay this means you have to memorize these five verbs which we start with كسرة even the third letter has dhamma. This will not confuse you, inshallah. طيب, this, we get rid of this now. Here the exercise, read the following underlined words on time. One time starting reading with it, and another time starting reading with the previous word. طيب, here, this word, you think how, if I'm gonna connect this with this, this alif ساكن, and this letter ساكن. What to do for the first ساكن? We said if it is mad letter, we have to drop it. This mean from the noon fatha to the hamza al-wasl. لقاءنأتي. ها؟ لقاءنأتي بقرآن. طيب؟ طيب, if I start with this, how I start? I start with hamza with kasra. And this hamza, I'm gonna switch it to ya. إيتي بقرآن, إيتي بقرآن. Same here. يقول, from the lam dhamma to the hamza. يقول ذلي. طيب, if I start with this hamza with kasra and this I switch it to ya. إيذلي. We switch only when it is hamza, huh? طيب, بئس, from the C to the lam kasr. بِسَالِسْمُ, بِسَالِسْمُ, بِسَالِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ. لا, lam this has a بِسَالِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ. أيوة. If I start with it, I could start a lism, or even without this hamza, I say lism. Why I start with lam without hamza? همزة الوصل, because the lam is kasra, it's not ساكن. I could get rid of it. I say لسم or أليسم. This in سورة الحجرات. Here, ربنا اكشف. What I do with the letter of the mad, it's ساكن. ألف always ساكن. I have to get rid of it, drop it. From the نون فتحة to the كاف. ربناك, ربنا اكشف. طيب, here, how I start? Notice there is dhamma on the third letter. Huh? What if you answer me? Open the mic, anyone, and answer. What I start this with? Huh?
Assalamu alaikum with dhamma.
Good girl. Mute yourself. اركض برجلك. طيب, here. إن افتريته, this noon suppose ساكن. And this ساكن, what I do, I have to get rid of the first ساكن by any of the ways. Either ضمة, either كسرة, either فتحة. Either I drop it when it is letter of the mad. The letter of the mad, we drop it. طيب, here, most of them, we said 90% of them, we put كسرة. إن افتريته. طيب. للذين كفروا امرأة نوح. كفروا, I have this well, letter of mad also. And I have ميم ساكن. What I do now? I drop the letter of the mad from the ره ضمة to the ميم. كفروا, كفروا امرأة نوح. و here also I drop this one. وامرأة لوط. وذكر اسم, from the ره فتحة to the سين. وذكر اسم ربه. Here I have this. أن يغدو, this suppose ساكن, I put كسرة. أن يغدو, from the نون كسرة to the غين. أن يغدو. طب, if I start with this one, because the third one has compulsory ضمة, I start with ضمة. أغدو, أغدو. طيب, أنمشو. What I start here with, the third one has dhamma, but it's not compulsory. I remember, أمشو is one of them. يبقى this mean I start with كسرة here. Either I say أنم, from the نون كسرة to the ميم, she, second, either I start this with أمشو, not omshu, ها imshu, one of the five verbs which the dhamma is temporary. Wasbiru, drop this, say was. Wasbiru على آلهتي. ومثل كلمة خبيثة كشجرة خبيثة نيج. From this the noon of the tanween is the second here. Noon of the tanween, noon second, right? And the jim second. How I get rid of the first second, which is noon of the tanween, I make kasra for it. Khabithatini, ni. After I make the ta and kasra, I make ni. If the noon of the tanween, aksarha, and then I go to the jim. Khabithatini jtuthat. If I start this word, I start with Dhamma because the third one compulsory Dhamma. Ujtuthat. Ujtuthat min fawqil. From the qaf to the lam. Min fawqil ard. Here I start with Hamza with Kasra because there's no Dhamma here. Irji'i. And always after Hamzat al-Wasl, we have Ra Mufakhama. Remember this. Always after همزة الوصل you have ره مفخمة. ثكرة. إرو. إرجعي إلى ربك. Okay. Let me see what's here. اذهب إلى فرعون. In the word إيتي here. We can't start it إيتي, huh? Because the همزة second after همزة we switch the other همزة. According to, if you put كسرة you change it to ياء. If you put ضمة you change it to واو. If you put فتحة you change it to ألف and so on. When the reader starts reading from Hamza till Wasl, this is followed by a Hamza that has sukoon. So the reader is supposed to change this Hamza into a ya mad, and that will be pronounced as et, because it's hard to pronounce two Hamza after each other and so on. Here, gonna tell us about what time you drop the letter of the mad before Hamzat al-Wasl. He starts with Lam Ta'rif, presence of Lam Ta'rif before a noon, a noon makes it definite. I'm sorry, a noun. Before a noun makes it definite. يعني بتعرفه. يعني تعريف يعني make it definite. Before Al Ta'rif, I don't know. Like, مثلا, if you say balad means country. I don't know which balad you're speaking about. But if you say هذا البلد, he's speaking about مكة. Okay. Now, لام التعريف should always be ساكن. ساكنة. لام التعريف only occurs as the second letter of a noun. It follows همزة الوصل. Let us see here. لام شمسية, لام قمرية. The letter that follows lam التعريف has شدة. شمسية شدة. You could connect this way, inshallah, will be easy. شمسية شدة. Lam التعريف will not be pronounced silent. It will be silent. يعني will not be pronounced, will be silent. Here, if you say al, but there is no sukun to say al. He say wal, wal jibala. From waw to lam second, I drop hamza til wasl. Tab here, I have to say a. Hamza was fatha because al, التعريف. But the lam, I can't pronounce it. Why? Because the lam merged with the noon and became noon shadda. Lam shamsiya, I don't pronounce it at all. It's silent. You say an. النهار. طيب. But this lam قمرية letter that follows lam التعريف doesn't have a شدة on it. لام التعريف is pronounced with a سكون on it. Like you say القمر. We call it لام قمرية because if you say القمر you have to pronounce the لام. But if you say الشمس you don't pronounce the لام. Then we make it with something يعني everybody knows how to read it. Here المرء. Here S. I didn't pronounce the لام. السماء. الكافر. الرحمن. You could memorize the letters which we merged with the lam, the letters of Shamsia. We could take this task later, inshallah, or the letters of Qamariya later, inshallah. طيب. Lam Shamsia should never have haraka on it because we merge it with the following letter. Then we leave it without haraka. If you make merging, means idgham. For any letter with the following letter, we never put haraka on the first letter. No, never. Because we merged already. We switch it to seen. We switch it to noon. We switch it to ra. Khalas? Then we leave it without haraka. Means you don't pronounce it at all. Pronounce the second one. The lam qamariya should always have sukun sign on it. طيب, now, very important rule concerning Hamza al-Wasl. If Hamza al-Wasl is preceded by a mad letter preceding it, the mad letter is directly connected to the letter that follows Hamza al-Wasl. لا, he said وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ. لا, I think he didn't explain this very good. Anyway, here he said is preceding by a mad letter. The letter preceding صح كده. The letter preceding the mad letter means the ذال here. Is directly connected to the letter that follows همزة الوصل. Means we drop the letter. If he say like this will be easier. We drop the letter of the mad. وإذا ذل وإذا البحار إذا السماء. اللام also I don't pronounce, I didn't pronounce a scene only. يا أيها الإنسان, from the ها to the لام I drop the ألف because it's following by ساكن, it's following by ساكن. I have to get rid of the first one if it is letter of the مد. إذا إذكتل, إذكتل from the ذا فتحة to the كاف. طيب, you have exercise here. You could try to solve it, inshallah. مهرية will send you these pages. And if you have any question, ready, inshallah, to hear from you. Open your mic and ask if you have any question. If not, we close, inshallah. Any question? Look like there is no question. Everything is clear, alhamdulillah. طيب, جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.